Hi everybody, Dr. D again, and as you know, today we're on the topic of memory, and the title for this particular series of videos is Remind Me to Remember. So when we're talking about memory, we're talking about impressions that come through the five senses and ultimately end up within the context of a sentence that you've heard me describe on a frequent basis, and that is that you and I are the biological end product of our interpretation of our perceptions, and memory is part of that. And so one of the things that happens when memory is corrupted or compromised is very simple, and that simple fact is that we don't pay attention, we fail to observe, we fail to concentrate, and we fail to impose our will on our desire to recall a given set of facts. And so all of this knowledge that you've acquired through the five senses that gets stored as part of the memory system can either get stored randomly or they can get stored in a very systematic manner, which make them much easier to retrieve. And all of this depends on the intensity of the impression, the degree to which you pay attention to the observation, and the degree to which you concentrate on that which it is that you're perceiving through your senses that is now being stored in the subconscious portion of your mind for retrieval at a later date. Now, there are a lot of tools and techniques for developing this skill. If it's something that you don't have, that's actively engageable by you. And these are things that I'm going to talk about in detail in a series of audios on our membership site. So if you're interested in that, by all means, look into, inquire, ask about how you can become part of the Matrix membership site. And I'm going to be explaining in detail not only how the concept of memory works, but how you can enhance your ability to improve your memory. And so in doing so, I hope you'll join me either on the membership site or in the next series of videos where we deal specifically with memory, the biochemistry of memory, and the psychological and emotional components associated with a compromised memory. So until then, I'm Dr. Richard DiCenzo. Thank you for watching.